Good morning, brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to morning prayer on this Wednesday of the 18th week after Pentecost, Proper 21, Year A. Our readings for this morning are as follows. Old Testament reading, 2 Kings chapter 18, verses 28 to 37. The Gospel reading is from the Gospel of Matthew chapter 7, 13 to 21. The Psalms are Psalms 101 and Psalm 109, verses 1 to 4 and 20 to 30. The preface of Proper 21. Please join us in our opening hymn.
Mine is the sunlight, mine is the morning, born of the one light, Eden saw play. Praise with elation, praise every morning, God's recreation of the new.
Our service continues from page 32 of our Book of Common Prayer with the opening sentence and then on to page 35 and following. Through Jesus, let us continually offer up to God the sacrifice of praise, that is a tribute of lips which acknowledge his name. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Blessed be the Lord our God, by whose grace we are yet alive. Blessed be his Son, Jesus Christ, by whose rising we are set free. Blessed be the Spirit of God, in whom is our hope and our joy. Continuing in prayer. Father, We come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship bear witness to your peace and saving power through your Spirit. May we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. Divinity. O come, let us sing out to the Lord. Let us shout in triumph to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his face with thanksgiving and cry out to him joyfully in psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hands are the depths of the earth, and the peaks of the mountains are his also. The sea is his, and he made it. His hands molded dry land. Come, let us worship and bow down, and kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he himself is our God. We are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. If only you will hear his voice today, for he comes. He comes to judge the earth. He shall judge the world with righteousness, and the people with his truth. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. And now let us approach the God's throne of mercy, seeking his forgiveness with reverence. Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in the newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Set us free, O God, from the bondage of our sins, and give us the liberty of that abundant life, which you have made known to us in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Psalms appointed for today are Psalms 101 and Psalm 109, verses 1 to 4, and 20 to 30. Psalm 101. I will sing of the mercy and justice. To you, O Lord, will I sing praises. I will strive to follow a blameless course. O, when will you come to me? I'd walk with sincerity of heart within my house. I will set no worthless thing before my eyes. I hate the doers of evil deeds. They shall not remain with me. A crooked heart shall be far from me. I will not know evil. Those who in secret slander their neighbors, I will destroy. Those who have a haughty look and a proud heart, I cannot abide. My eyes are upon the faithful in the land, that they may dwell with me. And only those who lead a blameless life shall be my servants. Those who act deceitfully shall not dwell in my house, and those who tell lies shall not continue in my sight. I will soon destroy all the wicked in the land, that I may root all the evil doers from the city of the Lord. Psalm 101. I will sing of the mercy and justice to you, O Lord, will I sing praises. I'll try to follow a blameless course. O, when will you come to me? I'll walk with sincerity of heart within my house. I will set no worthless thing before my eyes. I hate the doers of evil deeds. They do not remain with me. A crooked heart shall be far from me. I will not know evil. Those who in secret slander their neighbors, I will destroy. Those who have a haughty look and a proud heart, I cannot abide. My eyes are upon the faithful in the land, that they may dwell with me. And only those who lead a blameless life shall be my servants. Those who act deceitfully will not dwell in my house, and those who tell lies shall not continue in my sight. I'll soon destroy all the wicked in the land, that I may root out all evildoers from the city of the Lord. Psalm 109. Hold not your tongue, O God of my praise, for the mouth of the wicked, the mouth of the deceitful, is open against me. They speak to me with lying tongue, they encompass me with hateful words, and fight against me without a cause. Despite my love, they accuse me, but as for me, I pray for them. They repay evil for good and hatred for my love. But you, O Lord, my God, O, deal with me according to your name. For your tender mercy's sake, deliver me. For I am poor and needy, and my heart is wounded within me. I have faded like a shadow when it lengthens. I am shaken off like a locust. My knees are weak through fasting, and my flesh wasted and gaunt. I have become a reproach to them. They seek and shake their heads. Help me, O Lord my God. Save me for your mercy's sake. Let them know that this is your hand, that you, O Lord, have done it. They may curse, but you will bless. Let those who rise up against me be put to shame, and your servant will rejoice. Let my accusers be clothed with disgrace, and wrap themselves in their shame as in a cloak. I will give thanks to the Lord with all my mouth. In the midst of the multitude will I praise the Lord. Because he stands at the right hand of the needy to save his life from those who would condemn him. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Our first reading, the Old Testament, is taken from the book of 2 Kings, chapter 18, verses 28 to 37. Then the Rabshakeh stood and called out in a loud voice in the language of Judah. Hear the word of the king of Assyria. Thus says the king, do not let Hezekiah deceive you, for he will not be able to deliver you out of my hand. Do not let Hezekiah make you rely on the Lord by saying, the Lord will surely deliver us, and this city will not be given into the hand of the king of Assyria. Do not listen to Hezekiah, for thus says the Lord of Assyria, make your peace with me and come out to me. Then every one of you will eat from your own vine and your own fig tree, and drink water from your own cistern. until I come and take you away to a land like your own land, a land of grain and wine, a land of bread and vineyards, a land of olive trees and honey, that you may live and not die. Do not listen to Hezekiah when he misleads you, saying, the Lord will deliver us. Has any of the gods of the nation ever delivered its land out of the hand of the king of Assyria? Where are the gods of Hamad and Arpad? Where are the gods of Sephavim, Hena, and Eva? Have they delivered Samaria out of my hand? Who among all the gods of the countries have delivered their countries out of my hand, that the Lord should deliver Jerusalem out of my hand? But the people were silent and answered him not a word, for the king's command was, do not answer him. Then Eliakim, son of Hilkiah, who was in charge of the place, and Shebna, the secretary, and Joah, son of As, the recorder, came to Hezekiah with their clothes torn and told him the words of the Rabshakeh. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen. Continue the Benedictus. Blessed are you, Lord God of Israel. You have come to your people and set them free. You have raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of your servant David. Through your holy prophets, you promise of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our forebears and to remember your holy covenant. This was the oath you swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship you without fear, holy and righteous before you, all the days of our life. A new child shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for he will go before the Lord to prepare the way, to give God's people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine upon those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Continuing with the Gospel reading. A reading from the Holy Gospel of Matthew, chapter 7, begin at verse 13 and on to 21. Enter through the narrow gate, for the gate is wide and the road is easy that leads to destruction, and there are many who take it. For the gate is narrow and the road is hard that leads to life, and there are few who find it. Beware of false prophets who come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly are ravenous wolves. You will know them by their fruit. Are grapes gathered from thorns or figs from thistles? In the same way, every good tree bears good fruit, but a bad tree bears bad fruit. A good tree cannot bear bad fruit, nor can a bad tree bear good fruit. Every tree that does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire. Thus you shall know them by their fruit. Not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who does the will of my Father in heaven. The Gospel of Christ. Praise to Christ, O Lord.
turning back, no turning back, no turning back, no turning
before me, the world behind me, the cross before me, no turning back, no turning.
So my brothers and sisters, I thank you for this opportunity to share my thoughts with you on this morning's gospel reading. I do so in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In our reading, Jesus continues his sermon on the mountaintop. The sermon contains the body of principles and codes of conduct or behavior for guidance of his disciples and his followers, and most certainly apply to us also. Those who desire Jesus cannot expect to live a life contrary to those guidelines and be accepted in the kingdom of heaven. Upon careful examination of the Sermon on the Mount, one can observe that it may be very difficult for some to follow because of their worldly beliefs. And so Jesus gives clear warning to follow if you wish to enter the kingdom of God. So he says one must enter through the narrow gate. In the same breath, he warns about that gate which leads to destruction is wide, and the road is easy to traverse. As Proverbs 16:25 tells us, sometimes there is a way that seems to be right, but in the end, it is the way to death. Jesus said that there are many who take it. They make that choice because the way is inviting, easy to follow, and the teachings are plausible. On the other hand, there is the narrow gate and the hard road that leads to life, which but a few will find. If we look at the teachings of Christ as the gate and the life we are expected to live and follow as a road, then we will understand why few will find it. For the worldly, the enticement of the worldly pleasures are not found within the narrow gate and on the hard road. But the way to eternal life requires entering and following the path guided by our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Our Lord is in fact the gate and the way. Jesus said, "I am the gate, and whoever enters by me will be saved and will come and go and find pasture. He is the good shepherd." Again, at John 14:6, he assures us, saying, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." If we have such assurance, there is no need to look further. As Jesus indicates, to follow where he leads requires faith, endurance, and discipline. This is gleaned from the Sermon on the Mount. But this seemingly difficult life, which he calls us to adopt, is, and we hope to live, is the only life worth pursuing. It is the narrow gate and the hard road which leads to eternal life. And this is what we should choose. Those who choose the easy, comfortable way will not lack friends, and they will not lack companions. But in the end, they must account alone and may miss out on the best which God has thought up for us, thought up for the faithful, and that is the free gift of eternal life. And so, my friends, which gate and which road are you prepared to follow and to take? We need not be afraid or timid about the way. Hebrews 4:16 guides us in this. The Apostle Paul writes, saying, "For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weakness, but we have one who in every respect has been tested as we are, yet without sin. So we do have an exemplar to imitate in Jesus Christ. As he continued, Jesus warns about the deceitfulness which will confront believers as they endeavor to follow the straight and narrow. Their will to follow Christ is always marred by false prophets and false teachings, who are advocates of the more attractive way. They dilute his teachings and water down his truths. Eventually, nothing of God's filled and kingdom-centered doctrine is left. If we look at some of these prosperity preachers that we find today, we recognize these ravenous wolves in sheep clothing, which Jesus said to be beware of. There's absolutely nothing wrong with being wealthy, but not at the cost of truth and not at the cost of eternal life. Jesus' warning is everlasting, for in every generation there are vicious, unbelieving believers. They prey on the innocent and immature. They prey on the gullible and unstable members of the faith. To avoid being taken in, Jesus warns that we should be observant. Believers should look closely at those who present themselves as teachers in the church. They betray themselves by their lifestyle, their teaching, which run counter to his truths and his teachings. A person, just as a tree, produces fruit consistent with their character. Just as a good tree bears good fruit, and a bad tree bears bad fruit. So it is with man. This principle is true in the world, as it is. This truth is true in the spirit as it is true in the natural world. These who claim to speak for God, their lives and teaching must stand up to the testing of the word of God and not by some watered down doctrine intended to make them look good. They cannot be guided by some false doctrine concocted to make them appear to be godly. And this is what the Pharisees and their scribes did. They drew up legal documents, supposedly based on biblical law and theory, which they called the tradition of the elders, and demanded that the people follow them. And so it was that these ravenous wolves in sheep clothing fleeced the people of God. And this is not unlike certain situations today. Jesus declared that we are to watch for the fruits of those who come as prophets, for it is by their fruits that they will be known. He makes it clear that the final destiny of those who do not bear good fruit is to be cast into eternal fire. Jesus then warns about those who falsely claim to know him as Savior, saying, and have not followed his teachings, saying, that everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter into the kingdom of heaven, but only the ones who do the will of the Father in heaven. And in this regard, what we say or profess to be does not matter. What matters, or what counts in the end, is what we do, and that we do the will of the Father. This requires, firstly, that we believe in His Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Once we take the first step, then to follow through the narrow gate and along the hard road will not be as difficult as envisaged. And so we are guided, and we should be willing to go through the narrow gate and follow the hard road to eternal life. And my dear friends, may God grant us His grace to follow His Son where He leads. The Lord be with you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We continue now with the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. By way of intercession, we continue to pray for God's abundant blessing upon his people. We pray for those who are caught up in so many wars, distressed by natural disasters. We pray that relief will come to them soon. Lord, in your mercy, please hear our prayer. We pray for the Anglican Church worldwide, that God will bless our leaders and guide them along the right path. In our province, we pray for our provincial Archbishop, the Most Reverend Howard Gregory. We pray for our diocesan bishop, the Right Reverend Claude Berkeley, thanking God for strengthening him and keeping him to do his wonderful work in this diocese. We pray for all retired bishops. Today, in the Diocesan Cycle of Prayer, we pray for St. Agnes, St. James Port of Spain, where the bishop gives oversight. And we pray for those who see to the daily management of that church. In our own parish, we pray for the Reverend Father Dr. Anderson Maxwell, and those who assist him, Reverend Father Titus Akbarali, and Reverend Presbyter Pontifleck Andre. We pray God's blessing on them as Father Akbarali recovers from his illness, and Reverend Pontifleck from her injury. We pray for the deacons in the parish, Deacon Rodin Fanfair and Mark Haynes, and myself. We pray for the laity and all the church groups, remembering our former rector, Canon Gemmett Hazelwood, thanking God for preserving him and keeping him. We bring the congregations of our parish to our Maker, seeking his divine assistance as we seek to forge forward with the congregation at Oropoon. Pray for the congregation at St. Philip's Lopino, Maloney, St. Aidan's, and St. Mary. Remember the sick, those who cannot come out with us, the homebound, reminding them that they are not alone and that they should use this very valuable time to draw closer to God. We pray for those who have passed in the hope that they will receive God's rest. Continuing, we use suffrage C, page 44. Save your people, Lord, and bless your inheritance. Govern and uphold them now and always. Day by day we bless you. We praise your name forever. Lord, keep us from all sin today. Have mercy on us, Lord. Have mercy. Lord, show us your love and mercy, for we put our trust in you. In you, O Lord, is our hope, and we shall not hope in vain. continuing the preface proper 21. O God, you declare your almighty power chiefly in showing mercy and pity. Grant us the fullness of your grace, that we, running to obtain your promise, may become partakers of your heavenly treasure. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Returning to page 45, we pray. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend ourselves this day. Let your presence be with us this close. Strengthen us to remember that in whatever good works we do, we are serving you. Give us a diligent and watchful spirit, that we may seek in everything to know your will, and knowing it may gladly perform it to the honor and glory of your name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The prayer of dedication. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our path, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit. And in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us evermore. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, our service is finished. Let us now go in peace and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. Father,